7 hours looking for a perch.
This is 39 hours spanning from early Saturday morning until late Sunday night on the last weekend of May. Three teams spread over thousands of miles are competing to catch the biggest fish of as many different species as they can. Team Shimano is Paul Castellano and Taro Murata. Team Manitoba is Aaron Wiebe and Manny Milas. Team Saskatchewan is Adam Konrad and Sean Konrad. 1 point is available for the longest legal fish of any species over 12 inches. Each point is worth a dozen Shimano rod and reel combos for kids fishing initiatives of that team's choice. The team with the most points held at the end of the weekend are the champions. This is 39 Hours, presented by Travel Manitoba. Canada's heart beats.
You can see the boat launch is just to the right here, Petrovka Bridge. We haven't been here for a while, but we used to fish here when we were younger all the time. Catch sturgeon right off that boat launch there.
Yeah, we'll go try to mark some deeper pools out there.
I was starting to feel delirio when we were driving over here.
For the viewers or anyone watching, delirio is a case of anglers' overexhaustion, right, Paul?
I don't think they understand,
they
though.
They don't understand. You have to really fish for so many days in a row and not sleep for so many days in a row and get, like, blasted by wind and sun and be sunburnt and dehydrated. That's severe delirio.
Severe delirio.
And then I see 4D on the road. You got to pull over when you see 4D. It's, like, more than 3D.
So we fished largemouth this morning, and then we decided to come out here for walleye, and things went horribly wrong, and we decided to troll. So we trolled and caught nothing, and then after trolling for nothing, we decided to catch perch, and we have literally gone a complete 360 around the eastern basin of Lake Erie looking for perch, and we're back exactly where we started. We haven't gained any ground since 6:30 or 7 this morning.
It's unbelievable.
It is unbelievable.
Tomorrow you're gonna go there and the fish are gonna be there. And
now
let me tell you something, Mother Nature's bigger than you, brother.
I agree. This concept though, this fishing continuously for 39 hours, it's a challenge. It's not as easy as you think.
Sleep is important, man. It really is.
We're headed to the Red River, the most prolific river in Canada, perhaps in North America, for multi-species, and we are going to capitalize on as many species as we can.
We had a couple of the most devastating losses
in sport fishing history.
In sport fishing history, yeah. All right, just Team Manitoba signing off for now. We're on our way to our wheelhouse.
This is just for a gold eye to start. We could have one guy fishing for sturgeon most of the time.
Once you hammer off a gold eye, maybe we could try to find a deeper hole.
Yeah, and then we'll be more walleye there too, or bigger ones. So you just got a worm.
Pretty much just Lindy rigging it.
If I really want a goldeye, I just kind of do a stinger, and then they'll grab this back piece right away, and you should hook them first bite. That's the plan, at least.
Now we wait. And a hit there.
Got him?
No. Hit again, though.
Could be walleye. Oh, yeah. There. A sauger.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, that's a sauger. Yeah. Pretty sure. Check it out.
Yeah, it's a sauger.
Yeah, sauger.
Oh, a hook popped out.
Look at that, we got a new species, boys!
Sauger!
15 and a half inch.
Yeah. We don't catch too many of those, so that's good.
This is a good spot for some walleye. We could get our 26 incher here.
Yeah. Start running some bigger cranks and stuff.
We're kind of going for sturgeon, so that's why we're using bait.
Yeah.
Fish.
Perch?
Smallmouth.
Bigger though?
No.
Same size.
I don't know.
You know what I think, kid?
What? You gotta get out of here?
I think we just gotta take our losses and
go for carp.
Yeah, we gotta do something different. Try to get another species or two.
Swiss Chalet though. On
no,
the way.
There'll be no Swiss Chalet.
Not getting any gold eye bites for sure, but
I still think if we could find like a drop, if it goes to 12 feet or something, it'll be one of the deeper parts of the river, right?
We just do it quick. These kind of 8 foot stretches though will hold big walleye.
Yeah, oh for sure, walleye. But we're here to find
multiple species.
We're in sturgeon mode right now, or sucker mode, or goldeye mode.
Yeah. If we want to get walleye, it's going to be around 7.
Yeah.
For the bigger ones, right?
Yep. True that.
Yeah. And you're right. Like they're kind of everywhere, right?
Yeah, they are.
But while we're out here, we might as well see if we could find a deeper hole. We have a little bit of time.
Open that up. Let's see how big 29 inches is.
That's big, bro. Forget it. No carp.
No, you don't give up, but that is a big carp.
You can't beat that. Now what? They commercially fish for perch on this lake, which means they have billions and we can't catch one. Not one, not even a bite. Why can't I be so clutch right now? The perch put me in fetal position. Carp, no, it's 29 inches, too big. Perch, crappie, suckers. The perch turned us into suckers.
9 feet here. It's the deepest spot I've found so far. Oh, 9.4, 9.7, 10.
Look at that little back current there.
10.4.
And look at the 10.7. Stops. Right here is going to be a sturgeon spot. Okay, go up a bit.
We're 11 feet now. Now we're coming up. We're going to be right on the hump here.
That's some crazy back current, eh?
What do you think, right here or what?
Yeah, keep going up a little bit more.
Hey.
How's
it going?
Good. Okay, we're gonna drop here.
What's your secret? Well, how are you finding fish here?
Well, it's a nice back eddy right there.
I thought you were using you have a depth finder or something?
Yep, you're sitting in my spot right now.
Are you?
Yeah.
Well, look at it.
So how deep are we here?
You're about 10 feet.
This is the first time we've ever fished here.
We've never fished at this spot before.
Yep.
So.
We need a couple species. Like, hold on up again.
It's huge.
I'm just trying to think.
Oh, it's big, man.
Not really, man.
No.
Like, it's a good, like, I'm thinking carp in my hands.
Yeah, the giant ones are like that, right?
Yeah, the big ones are like this, man. I think everybody's within a point or two. This last round is key.
Yeah, who can push through?
Got something going. Oh yeah, that's a good take. That could be a sturgeon take. No. Oh, you know what that's?
Is it a gold eye?
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
Yep.
We need a gold eye.
I know.
Where are you?
I'm right here.
You got your small stuff on?
Yeah.
Chuck it back further.
Yeah.
That's where the 11-foot hole is there.
Those are gold eye bites. If you don't hook it and they're biting like that, it's not a sturgeon.
Okay, so it's 5:20. We've got till 10 p.m. this evening, and then that's it. 39 hours is over. So the last move we're gonna make, we're back in the truck, pick up some supplies, head to another location and set up, and we're gonna be hopefully targeting common carp and possibly some channel catfish. And it is what it is. You know, there is an opportunity for sheephead right there, so we'll probably take a stab at that just because. Can we get a 25 incher? Maybe.
Yeah, there you go.
Hopefully this is a gold eye or something.
You could come around this side and land him in the slack here. Oh yeah, it's a gold eye.
Big one too.
That's what we're looking for.
It's a mini tarpon. Here it comes. Oh.
Oh,
oh damn.
This is our final stop.
We are flying up this creek, tributary of the Red River. There's gonna be a lot of bumping around going in this period as people are competing for specific points. And when somebody takes that point, it's a 2-point fluctuation because somebody loses a point, somebody gains a point. Right now, we are hunting down a white bass.
Big, giant, white bass.
Let me know if you can see current at this bend.
Not seeing any, but I wouldn't mind fishing this little stretch.
Please be a big white bass.
Uh-oh.
Is that a drum?
Yep.
We need that size in a white bass.
Oh, yes.
Beauty. Hammer that swim bait.
Bang, that's what that's all about. It's a big drum.
Those drummers are so into that, it's ridiculous.
They really are, yeah.
Me too, Manny.
They're into that too.
Well, we got a little drum hole here. Look at how deep he took that swim bait. That's a 4-inch swim bait. Barbel hook, because we're in Manitoba. Just ingested. These fish are in here eating minnows. Nice and fat. We got a lot of water we can cover.
Oh yeah.
Let's move.
We found a nice back eddy here. It's the deeper part of the river within a couple miles. I think we're past the point of being tired, so that just doesn't matter anymore.
The no sleep factor is huge. You don't think the same as if you're rested. You know, you make some bad calls, you make some good calls, but it ain't over yet.
There we go.
Bring them in that slack current, be good. We just gotta be light on them here. lost a few, and it's just it's how it is. Same as whitefish, hey, we lose a lot of them. They got really soft mouths.
Oh, here's a good jump.
Oh, sturgeon. It's a sturgeon.
Little guy, though.
Okay, I could put a little more pressure. Little sturgeon.
I was wondering why he wasn't doing head shakes. Good stuff. I don't think that's a 36 inch.
No, it's like...
Or should I get that bigger net just in case?
It's not that big. It's like, what, 5 pounds?
Here he is. There we go. That's a little guy.
Little tiker.
Yeah, be careful of those spikes. Those ones are sharp.
Oh, 28 and a quarter if I twist it like that. I can't believe this is a 28 inch fish. It looks like 2 pounds.
Crazy spikes on him.
There he goes. Well, there's sturgeon in the area. Just not big ones.
Well, one, there's going to be more.
Yeah.
Cruising along here and just hitting every corner in the river. Every time there's a corner in the river, there's going to be a deep spot on the outside edge and definitely a back eddy. See the water turning the other way?
Yeah.
Firing. No time like the present. You want to see some white bass, huh?
Oh, there's a hit. Bam. Oh.
I love how you saw it. I love how it was so hard that you saw the strike.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to get that one. Don't worry, we'll follow it.
Oh, boom, on! Yes!
That's, I don't know if that's him.
It's the same. It's your fish.
No, but that's not where
it's
cast.
A monster, too.
Is it?
Oh, yeah. Get the net. Get the net. Get the net. It's staying down. I don't think it's a drum either, dude. I hope it's not a drum. I would say, get the net. Oh, yes! In, yes, yes, buddy. Yes!
That's a big white bass. I think we're there already.
Our first bass.
Blocky belly.
Yeah, and a nice one. Look at this, white bass.
I don't know if that's gonna go now. It's close.
It's close, let's check it
I
out.
I think that's gonna be a 15er.
We might have to keep fishing. Close the mouth, and we have 14 and a quarter.
I'm on.
Oh, he's on, get him.
Oh, I got a drum. That wasn't on purpose.
Yeah, right. Bye-bye.
Action.
Action.
Gotta love the action.
Yes. They're so thick in here.
I get like 3-4 hits a cast sometimes. I'm serious, it's the smaller ones and stuff, it'll be like thunk.
There's one. Okay, get your rod in.
Yeah.
I'm gonna bring them
Bring them right. over, just loosen the drag right off. Yeah. Just get this one in first. Yeah. Doesn't matter how long it takes. Do you mind if I throw mine out in the current?
Yeah, go behind there.
Yeah,
and then stick it there. I'll keep them to the right here. We're getting some action now.
Yeah, the fish are kicking up. Gold eye.
Moon eye, maybe. It's okay, it's okay.
Sorry.
Got him. Yeah. Yeah, that's a little gold eye. They get much bigger than this, but this is gonna be, put us on the board here. 14 inch. Yep. I'll get this guy back here.
Good job, Sean.
Yeah. All right, I'll show you what I'm gonna do.
Change in rigs.
Yeah. Get one species, change it up. The walleye are gonna be tight to bottom, so I wanna stick close to bottom. So I'll just put a heavy weight on. I'm gonna put a minnow on. I'm just gonna drag the minnow back.
On.
Nice. Nice.
Oh. Net. Or it might be a drum, but get the net, I'm not sure.
White bass, baby, white bass. Baby.
Oh yeah. Kind of looks like a cookie cutter of the other one. And they're so fun to catch on these little crankbaits, these white bass. They're just awesome. They're a lot of fun. Here comes another one. I'll check this one. Gotta be around 14 or so. Close the mouth on there. It's over 15.
It is?
Yes, sir.
Get the shot. Get the visual. 15.25. Mouth closed?
Mouth closed.
Legit, baby.
Oh, they're loaded in here.
Stolen. Point stolen.
Successfully stolen. Well, we're here at our last stab. We're going for a carp. It's going to be hard. Hopefully we can do it. We wasted so much time on that perch. 7 hours looking for a 12-inch perch. We couldn't even get a 2-inch perch. We're really fried, and I don't know what to tell you. We're delirious.
Yo, Taro, will you hold this, buddy? Taro, keep it off that concrete, okay?
Yeah, I'll try my best.
Please?
He don't want to scratch off his new Alumacraft beauty.
He needs to get a little grimy here. Uh-oh, I hit it. Don't tell him. Don't show him that footage.
I got fish. This will be a walleye.
Does it feel decent or what?
He's probably got it pretty good.
Oh, it's that's a sauger.
Sauger.
Fish are picking up right before the storm, so yeah.
There's a real sauger.
That looks a little bigger than mine, hey?
Yep.
Almost looks like the same fish.
It does look like the same fish. This one's 15 and a half. Nice.
That looked like the same fish, didn't it?
With the bent, right? That other one we caught way up there, though.
I know, I'm just kidding.
So there's no way.
I'm kidding.
Right now he's looking for perch. It might just change our plans a bit, because that's a key fish for us right now. That might just put us over the top. I can't believe it, I'm saying this, but it might.
It's up to you, Taro. Do you want to stab at all these on the way out?
Hell yeah.
Let's get our perch stuff then.
I'm just going to use a soft plastic minnow.
Whatever you want, kid.
Oh, first perch.
Oh my God.
We got a perch. There. You have no idea how hard we worked for this giant perch.
They're dink bites, but they're here.
Got one. Dink. It's going to be a wean through them out. Unbelievable. Little sausages. That's a big milestone we just passed today, though. We actually landed perch. Not one, but two. On camera. Two perch. Do you think we can get a 12-incher?
Yes.
Here, kitty.
Okay, let's fish it. Look at this. See this mud line? That is the Red River water. This is the water coming out of this creek. We are right on this line. Got the advantage of the slacker water off of the main river and the warm water coming out of the creek, and there's fish lined all along this seam. We got the anchor down and we're just swinging out, and we are gonna target right on this edge right here. Manny and I are doing totally different things. I've got a pickerel rig with worms to just get miscellaneous bullhead, drum, whatever. Manny's gonna go in with sucker, which is the best thing to use in spring for cat.
I'm just rigging up here. I've got a 2-ounce bell sinker. This is a very simple catfish rig.
If only Paul and Taro could see me now trying so hard to beat their 12-inch bullhead.
On.
Found them. Okay. I almost feel guilty. I'm targeting.
Bullheads.
Bullheads. Okay.
Oh, beautiful.
There's two.
Two.
Hey, Team Shimano, we are coming for you two at a time.
Take that.
These ones aren't big enough, but if we're catching them at this rate.
Do it.
I got bites.
And nice on fish.
Yes, sir. Check it out. Oh, I just had another hit.
Did it feel like a bullhead?
Yeah. It's a bullhead strike. My biggest concern, though, is we need a kitty cat.
Sure there's a lot of pressure on you.
Yeah, I'm feeling it. This is not good.
Okay, well, I can continue fishing for walleye. Gamagatsu in the nose of the minnow, and then drag it around the bottom and try and find a fish.
Oh! Yeah, I got it. That's something good.
He dropped it and smacked it again there.
Energetic one. It's a bigger sauger too.
Oh, that's bigger, yeah. So he's 17 and a quarter. 17 and a half I could pinch out there. Get this guy back. Nice.
Just had a bite. Just had another bite. Oh, getting better, Paul.
Oh, get him in. Whoa.
Almost net.
The pink provoker.
9.
3 hours, buddy.
You gotta be kidding me.
We're wasting time. These are peanuts.
You don't think there's 12-incher in here?
I don't know. What do you think?
I think so.
Somewhere, eh?
One more slot.
Go down the other side.
Yeah.
Taro's got his 18th wind right now. We're getting perch, but they're way too small. We can't even meet the 12-inch minimum requirement, but it's all good. We got 3 hours left. It's just past 7 o'clock. I was using minnows and getting micro fish, but he was getting 9-inchers to my 2.5-inchers on plastic, so go figure. We will do this just for a bit longer, and then we're gonna go set up and try to catch a Great Lakes carp, a 31-incher. That's the goal.
You're falling asleep every time I look over at you.
I'm not sleeping.
It's pathetic.
Shut up. I'm not sleeping.
You can't even stay awake during the most riveting tournament challenge there's ever been.
Oh my goodness. What's our next move after this, Aaron?
I think we can get channels up at the dam with how conditions have changed, the water warming up. But bullhead would be really nice to get here, as silly as that sounds.
We can still get a cat here too.
Look out. This one's bigger than the last couple, I don't know. Oh, there's two though. There's another double for you. I don't like how the size is all the exact same.
I don't like that either. Cookie cutters. What are you thinking?
The dam, I guess. Because you're not getting them here. You cool with that?
Yep.
ridiculous. We're pitching docks for 6-inch perch and we're like intense.
Big perch?
Ooh. Ooh, it's pulling drag. Oh, it's a sunny. Never mind.
12 inches?
No way. It's round and it's not 12 inches.
No good.
455. We're just trying to tag a big walleye here.
And sturgeon.
And Adam's going for sturgeon, I'm going for walleye here. Try to take some of those points away from the other teams here.
We got 2 hours left.
Yo.
Jumbo?
Big rock bass. Does it count?
Absolutely.
Oh, net. That's over 12 inches, man. That's a huge rock. You're the panfish whisperer.
It's because of your guidance and advice you gave me.
It's gonna measure, man.
Let's see, I don't think so. I think it's short. Look at that. 11 and a half.
No.
11 and a half inch rock bass.
Boo. Boo.
Ah, so close. That's a big rock bass though. Oh my God, there's a giant perch right there.
Oh, that's the one. It's a giant. Get a minnow.
I'll keep him interested. Okay, we got a chance here. We got about a 13 inch perch. It's the first one we've seen all day. He's staring at my bait, buddy.
Just try to make him eat.
Taro, he's just swimming away. He's cruising this way. Go towards number four.
Number four?
Number four. Just throw it 10 feet past my line. Get ready. That's the one. That's it. Just catch that fish. It's here. You got a minnow. I'm doing the same.
Net.
That's not the same
one,
though.
It's not the same one.
No, no. Damn.
Not even close. Something about competitive fishing to be said. I cannot believe how stoked we both are over this opportunity right now for one stupid perch. Just eat the minnow, let's get this over with and move on. I'm on.
That's not a perch. Is it a perch?
It is. It's a perch.
Get the net, Taro.
Handfish master. We're gone.
Hold on.
Oh my God. It's a giant.
Go.
We got him. Oh
yes.
My
yes. Yes. So I can't freaking believe it. Bring this in. There it is.
There it is.
That's it.
Game over,
oh yeah,
baby.
With the perch whisperer, last minute efforts, unfreaking real. Let's just verify it. Oh yeah, 14 inch yellow perch.
Not
right there.
Not.
Oh, we got another 30. One too. Just for measures. That's the other one we saw. That's it right there. Team Shimano, then you're done
so
in the dying minutes.
8 hours
Ow!
For this.
That's it. Let's go. That was amazing. Amazing. 14 inch yellow perch. Done. Okay, let's go.
Bye-bye.
That was freaking epic.
Just one more last thing to say. One more last thing.
Yeah!
That fish was so clutch, buddy.
Well, this is the famous Lockport, Manitoba. It's an incredible place where a lot of people come to fish, and I've called it home for years. Right now, we've got all the locks but one are open, and as you can see, there's some pretty powerful current going through there.
What do you think over by the fish ladder there? It's a pretty fast eddy, isn't it? There are so many fish in here.
Oh, I believe it.
There's a million. So we're in a hardcore eddy here. We're gonna try to anchor nose into it up here and cast behind us. The eddy's gonna be ripping around here. We got a fish way that we gotta keep a little bit of distance from, but there's absolutely a ridiculous amount of fish in here. Okay, so I'd be cool with you putting the anchor in anytime.
All right.
Like now. Where'd you cast?
Just right here. I didn't even go far. I already got hits. I got a fish. Right now, oh, it's just, look at my line, just, that's a hit.
Well, there's so many fish hitting the line, right? Oh, like it's outrageous. How are they not eating
that? I don't understand it either.
Okay, I'm seeing carp in there now too.
What do we gotta be for a carp, 31?
29 and a half, I think.
Really?
Now a lot of those are looking like carp. Carp. Are they all carp? It's like I thought I saw all cats and now I'm seeing all carp.
Smacked a little walleye. Not the size we're looking for, but it's the species we're looking for. We need about three of these guys for length.
Yeah, combined.
Get back at her here.
We still got a bunch of rigging and stuff to do, so we should go there and set up, you know what I mean? We're gonna make one more move. We're gonna set up double anchor system. You know, it takes some time to get the fish in after we chum, so we're gonna throw some chum in the water.
Oh, you got hit.
Yeah, there you go. That's a bit better.
That could be one, eh?
We'll see.
Small.
No, it's not small, Adam. This is a better fish. Actually, this might be a sturgeon here. Yeah, this is a sturgeon. Or something big. Maybe a monster walleye. I'll go up to the front here with the current.
Nice and easy on him.
Yeah. Could even be a pike. Here he is on him.
Big walleye. This could be. Oh yeah, this is gonna be close.
Oh.
Yeah, this is a big walleye.
Got him.
All right.
I think we got him.
Oh yeah, that's gotta be close. All right, I was just using worms and a minnow
for sturgeon.
That's a nice walleye.
Come on.
Yep.
Oh yeah, it's just over. 26 and a half.
26 and a half.
Good job, Sean.
Yeah!
That's your fish, buddy.
We did it.
Woo! Team Saskatchewan Fishing Geeks.
Yeah. We are took a point away from Manitoba.
6:36.
We got lots of time left.
Let him go. Let him go, let him grow.
Nice head on that thing. Yeah, he's kicking out. Yep, there he goes. Just about an hour and 20 minutes left, so hopefully we could smack a sturgeon here. So I just put one worm on, and then I just threaded the eye of a minnow, and then I just took half a worm, and then I put that on there, clawed it all up, and that's like a sturgeon rig. And I was sitting, like, there's that still water, I was sitting right on the break there.
This isn't good. We need a fish concentrator, you know, besides just looking for cats. Where's a fish concentrator? Mouth of Netley sure seems good. You know in front of that how it's all slack there?
Yeah. And I would think those bullheads would definitely be there.
Yeah, but we're gonna burn so much time driving there.
Well, this is all we got here.
And it's hell.
Yeah.
Okay, we gotta go. We're not scoring. I finally snagged something. Like, oh, there's 1,000 fish in there and this is what I hook.
Yeah.
This is not a good omen. Let's get out of here.
Netley?
I don't know. Do we start driving unless we get a better idea, we just keep on cruising?
I guess so.
Because we could poke around for cats, but the reality is we need to get somewhere where we're going to catch multi-species. Mouth of a creek where we can catch bullhead. This is Channel Cavish Capital World, but it's in mayhem right now with the big waters coming through. All the gates are lifted, so we got to make a run downstream.
So I pre-made this and then froze it. And all this is cattle corn. It's inexpensive, it comes in a huge bag. But the corn itself is rock hard. You can't work with it, you can't use it. And if you used it for chum or for bait, and it's not cooked properly, it's actually like doesn't digest properly in the carp's stomach. So what we do is we boil it, slow boil with some sugar. You can add all kinds of different flavors to it. This is ground bait. This is my own recipe. My friend Tom Berry actually shared it with me and then I put a couple tweaks on it, but just another form of feed and chum to hopefully trick a 31 inch carp. So I'm in 3 feet here. Just behind me is an 11, 12 foot hole. So we're gonna set up just on the edge of it. We're gonna put our baits on the center of the hole, on the ledges of the hole, on the lip, and see what happens. But
we might get a catfish, we might get a carp.
Yeah, this spot here has channel cats in it at times. They're not Manitoba channel cats, but you never know. And the carp, one of the only problems with the carp here, sometimes there's a lot of small carp, but you know, it's part of the Great Lakes system, so you could catch a giant carp as well. Something that I've learned over the years, if you have good boat control and good boat positioning, whether it be using your outboard motor or using your Minn Kota trolling motor, or even as simple as anchoring properly, it can make a huge difference in your success rate.
The only thing better about my boat than yours is the talon.
Yes.
That's it.
This is my retro talon.
It takes a little bit more work.
Talon down.
Yeah, we thought we had a bigger fish on here. Pike just went crazy when he hit the minnow here. So we're gonna let him go. All right. Well, we're getting all the species right in the spot, North Saskatchewan River by Petrovka Bridge. We got sucker, goldeye, we got a small sturgeon and that big walleye, so. And the sauger, so everything's in here. You just got to get a big one of each species now.
So we're just going to get a little spread going right now. Just kind of take a mental note, Taro, where I'm throwing all this bait.
Mm-hmm.
Key is to get line in the water because the clock's ticking.
So this is a method feeder. It's weighted. You see this cage? When I'm ready, I'm going to pack this with that ground bait.
It's the final countdown.
Taro, you should set up your catfish rod. So this is called a bait needle. And just stack your corn on here or your maize. See how it's got a little hook on the end of it? And on the hair rake, there's a little loop. And what I do is I take the hook, so I attach that, and then I just simply pull the corn down onto that line.
This here is a little stopper, a little dumbbell, it looks like. And you put that on that loop, just like that. And then simply push the corn against that. And the idea is I want that corn sitting right against that hook. And this is pegged, this heavy weight. So essentially the carp comes along, sucks it up, goes to spit it out. It's gonna catch his lips, freaks out because of the weight, takes off, and sets the hook for you.
Basically all you do for the catfish rig, put a big egg sinker first, kind of opposite to the hair rig. The other one kind of pins it. The carp feels the weight and hooks itself. This one slides freely. The catfish can kind of take the piece of meat and slide and pull. And you don't want to set the hook with a circle. You kind of just start really, you know, just kind of catching the corner of his mouth. You don't gut hook him. Preserves the fish and your hookups are high. And that's it. Now time for the meat, Polly. Sucker! Little sucker steaks, nice and fresh. But through that nice meaty piece in the skin, eh? Expose that hook a bit.
So this is that ground bait, and I just mixed it with some water, and you can see how it went from like that dry, pasty to like a doughy consistency, right? And you just want to be able to form it into balls like that, and you know it's about the right texture. And then all I'm doing on this method feeder is I'm just going to pack a good size ball. It will slowly break down, you know, create a scent trail. There's some current here, and hopefully bring the carp over to my corn that I have. You know, sometimes I just take it, just kind of press it right inside there. That's totally up to you.
There we go. Love the Alumitrack system. Push it right down there. Now we just do is tighten it up at the bottom. Get your rod holder anywhere in the boat. Tighten her up.
And just want to make a nice lob gently. Kind of where you've been doing chum. Tighten up once it hits bottom. And the rod holder will go tip high. You want to put your bait runner on right away. You want to make sure that it's engaged. So I always test it. And then I put this little swing arm, it's called, here on. It puts tension on the beeper in case the fish hits it and comes towards you. We create slack, but this keeps tension on the wheel. So in case you doze off, which is very possible.
Manny fresh is probably Manny stale right now, eh?
We made the big run. We just drove half an hour. I'm just gonna zigzag until I find a concentration.
I don't know what all them's are, but there's a bunch of fish there. Right side of the boat. All smooth, and this side all speckled. I already marked that corner, that corner, that corner, that corner. Just throwing waypoints down, just so we got some reference points. That was kind of right in the mouth there, Manny.
Current is so light here.
There's the four corners. So we're anchored above it, and we're just gonna drop back in. We don't even have a clue what species these are. At this point, we don't really care what those fish are. We're in full scramble mode here.
Desperation.
Well, this feels like a really good chance of the bullhead.
59 minutes, 59 minutes, 59 minutes.
You know what happens when Adam and I get like the best cameraman ever? He goes overboard at the end.
Oh, no. Thanks, buddy!
It's gonna be very close. We're trying to get this sturgeon here. And if we get this sturgeon, we're gonna take a point away from Team Manitoba and we are gonna go up to 10. And they'd be, so they're gonna have to do four different species unless they upgraded.
When something that we've got.
That we've got, yes. Yeah. So it's gonna come down right to the wire. And Team Shimano is going to have to really pick up a lot of species at the end here. So.
Yeah, but if they have weather like this, I'm sure they could pound out species fast out there.
One to another.
It's nap time, nap
well,
time.
We're down to the last hour, T. This is it, man.
Paulie, he says, I thought it was kind of a racist comment, but he said, Taro, aren't you Japanese? If you get hungry, you can eat this raw bait. And, you know, I thought that was a little bit low class.
Taro's starting to slip, guys. He's getting a little crazy.
It's the final countdown. How many hours left?
We have 58 minutes, I think, left on the clock.
Ooh. Fish on, fish on!
Yeah, oh, yeah, buddy. Nice! Oh, we got a ripper.
29 inches, 29 inches.
Oh, buddy. Gone. Bye-bye, see ya on the rocks over there.
Oh, no.
100 yards away, right now. Oh no, it's gonna run the edge there.
I wanna double up on a cat.
We're in the 39th hour. I'm moving it too easy now. It feels kind of light.
Too small, eh?
Yeah, there's a lot of males in here. But you never know. It's just not over until it's over.
Yeah.
Hard to tell, I can't see, right? Made a wicked run though. Grab that net, T. It's right here.
It's pushing good water there.
Potential extra point fish.
Not good enough, man.
Yeah, you never know, kid. Let's get that in the net, head first. Nice and slow. Decent fish. The longer you have these things on, the more I pull, the more likely I'm going to tear that hook out. So the first chance you can.
Got him. Yeah, buddy.
Okay, wait, keep it right there in the water. I'm going to get the bump board ready. We're going to use both hands on this thing. We're going to try to keep it from flopping and hurting its head, so pick it up. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. I like what I'm seeing.
Oh my God. I didn't think we got it.
31 and a half inch. The last hour. Right there, boys.
We got it.
Whoa!
Unbelievable.
Okay. That's not it. That's not it. We actually drove half an hour to do more bullhead fishing. That's the smallest one we've gotten yet, but the bites are coming in hot and heavy. These are making those ones from earlier look big.
I think we got to switch up somewhere or something.
Mouth of Devils can be fishy. It's just around the corner. There's a deep hole just on the entrance to it. The outside of it can be okay.
I don't know, bud.
Well, we know it's probably not happening here, eh?
No. That would be our last run and gun, though.
Let's do it.
Let's end this with a bang.
You can use canned corn. Someone was probably saying, why does it go through all that trouble and boil it? Well, where we're from, we have these things called the round gobies. The canned corn you buy, it's just too soft. And the gobies, like, you'll cast it out there, you'll go through the effort, you'll be waiting. And they'll actually come in on it and just devour the corn without even moving the hook or the weight, so you won't even know you have them. So the maize is a much tougher outer shell, and the gobies can't just destroy it. You're so tired, eh? You still with us?
I'm with you.
How's your cut bait doing, buddy?
I don't know.
Tighten up that line, just have a little feel. Don't kid yourself, this is catfish hour. There's some big cats here, man. That would be an amazing, amazing point to take away from our farmer friend. I highly doubt it, but you never know. Stranger things have happened to us.
We steal that bullhead point, the crowd goes wild.
How shallow is that creek in there?
This one and that one are both pretty freaking shallow.
Are they?
Well, they have deep pockets of the mouth, though.
They do, huh?
Like 8 foot deep.
As soon as we dropped into here, you can see they're definitely related right to that bank, because there was a strip of fish there. So we've got 25 minutes to see what they are. Yeah. No more Mr. Nice Guy.
We should have just been mean from the get-go, though.
What's the deal with the final check-in? Nobody's saying anything.
Is that good or bad?
I don't know. Maybe it's supposed to be zero communication till the end. Cameraman Jacob, thank you so much for putting up with us.
Mr. Jacob Waters.
Good man.
Honestly, maybe we go to the boat launch, throw some lines out.
Yeah, let's do that. Go to the boat launch, throw some lines out, and we can pack the boat up.
Let's do it.
Because we've caught offshore there, and we're all rigged up.
There's a good backity there.
20 minutes.
Here we go already.
Oh boy, moment of truth. Are you scared?
A little.
We're still going hard in the paint. I hope everyone realizes that.
Boom, on. Good fish.
Buddy, if this is a bullhead, this is a
good,
big bullhead.
This is a big fish, whatever it is I got.
Mine's a big bullhead.
Oh, yeah.
That's a big
buddy,
bullhead.
Buddy, we did it. We did it.
Be
we
a
did
channel.
It. We did
be
it.
A channel.
We did it.
Be
we
a
did
channel.
It. Oh, two drum? Two drum.
Manny loves his doubles. Get on that.
Wow, what's up with the doubles all the time?
We just caught three fish.
That's amazing.
And this bullhead, we are hoping... Is that a 12-inch bullhead?
It will.
Folks, this might be the point stealer that we've sadly been trying for a long time. Manny, I don't know.
Is it?
Doesn't look good.
No, don't say that.
It's not there.
It's not.
It's not there.
Oh, man.
11 and a half. He's not there, but look, we're on a better average size and we have time left.
We have time
left. We're still going to steal this bullhead point. The fans will get what they want. They will see Team Manitoba prevail in the bullhead department. We have 16 minutes. That feels like tons of time.
We're getting to shore here to the boat launch. We're just going to throw the lines out and kind of organize here a bit.
Why don't you go down just a little bit? I'm just going to throw mine right here. Nice little 9-foot hole here. Because you never know.
All right.
Pure bait fisherman right here.
All right, well, let's just get this stuff packed up and you keep an eye on the time.
Lucky we got that rip, buddy, because it's not really on right now. Look at Taro's done. How done are you?
I'm really done.
How come, what's going on? What happened to you? You used all your emotion on the perch, didn't you?
I did.
Look at him, he's drained.
It was a lot of highs, a lot of lows, a lot of friends. A lot of foes. When you're fishing, anything goes. I'm happy that Paul and I are still bros. The end. How do you like that?
It's good.
We could do this yet.
I think this is called Devil's Creek, but I don't know for sure. And the fish aren't using the main river as much. You can see there's some crazy muck from the Red River that's all piled up there in a weird back eddy. And there's fish blown in here too. I don't think we're as zany as the Conrads are, because I don't know if they slept at all. If they take this, they truly earned it.
Yeah, absolutely. I got a lot of respect for those guys.
We got 10 minutes.
We have 10 minutes left. We're just gonna organize the boat and truck, and we got the lines out there. See if we can smack a sturgeon quickly here. Just need to be 36 inches. Fishing right to the end.
Catfish would be epic. Big one. Come on, you big feline, eat it.
If we couldn't even enter a channel cat, that's interesting.
And frustrating.
What?
Oh my God, that is your breath, actually.
Come on.
It is, man. I'm seriously standing like right here and I can smell your breath. Yeah, no more of that. No, but seriously, that's hilarious. Oh my goodness.
Uh-oh. You too?
No.
It rains, it pours?
Oh yeah. That's a bullhead.
Please, I think it is a bullhead. I'd get the net. Put the rod down.
It's not a bullhead. What are you doing?
Lifting the rod up.
Yeah, why? No.
Channel! We're such losers.
I know.
This is...
We did it.
Manitoba, home of the world-class channel cat. And here we are, measuring. Oh my goodness.
Oh no.
We owe the people of Manitoba such a huge apology.
Oh my goodness.
It's 18 inches.
Oh wow, that's a point.
It's just a swimming point.
Right on.
Back he goes. Oh. Okay, I gotta get back in there.
Good. Oh my goodness, I can't believe it. I'm ecstatic right now. Like, I didn't know if we were gonna get that or not. And here we come to this creek way out in the middle of nowhere, and we've got our cat, and it looks like we might get our bullhead. I don't know what this is. Check out that rod tip. Something's biting me here.
This is getting ridiculous. Big dumb goalie on the top hook, big dumb bullhead on the bottom hook.
I'm really not the bad guy, but they always edit it that way. I don't know why. Paul? You're the real bad guy. Maybe it's your blue eyes. Your blue eyes are too pretty. So, okay, we can't make him the bad guy.
We were both disappointed when we saw it was a channel and not a bullhead, and then realized how important it was, right? Yeah. Didn't you back off with the net at first? On.
Oh, wow. Come on, be a bullhead.
It could be.
It is, I think it is.
It is.
I'm ready.
This is the right one. Manny, honestly,
really?
Honestly.
Ah! Big drum.
Hey, just go back fish.
The old pickerel rig left.
6 minutes. 6 minutes, 6 minutes, 6 minutes, 6 minutes, 6 minutes. 6 minutes!
We need that bullhead now. Now. 5 minutes.
5 minutes. 4 minutes.
Bang, big hit. Okay.
Are you serious?
Yeah, big hit.
2 minutes. It just shifted to 2 minutes.
All right, I gotta get in there right now. Boom, I'm in. And I'm just gonna stare at the time.
This is it, kids. Last couple minutes.
Tick-tock, the choice is yours. Tick-tock, tick-tock, the choice is yours. Tick-tock, tick-tock. Give me a bowfin. Last minute. Oh my goodness, come on. It's the final countdown.
We got 1 minute, 60 seconds.
All right, it's like 7:59. We're just gonna reel our rods in. Wrap it up here. Thank you, Petrovka. Got yep. Some species here.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're done. I can't believe it's over. I'm kind of sad. I'm kind of happy. I'm kind of tired. I'm kind of toilet. So many mixed things going on. I don't want to express it all. Unbelievable. That's it. That's the end of 39 hours right there.
Yo. We did the best we could.
We did the damn best we could.
It involved a lot of autumn fishing. We had amazing fishing action basically throughout, besides a couple low periods, so absolutely no regrets. Had a lot of fun, and can't wait to see what the other boys did.
Thanks for watching.
Well, that was 39 hours. We gave it everything we had. I don't think we could have done any more. Maybe blackstrap perch, but that's really cutting it for time, so.
It was good. You know what, competitive guy in me, I think we could have done a lot better. I think we could have got bigger species and a couple more species, but it is what it is. 39 hours straight, one short nap, and I'm done. Let's get these rods in and head back to the dock and call her a night.
Slammed 16 different species this trip, my brother and I.
Good old Alumacraft did perfect. Everything worked out great.
It's gonna be interesting.
Yeah.
So obviously I didn't anticipate that this was even a possibility somehow. Yeah, that's the same consensus here, but Manny's already gone. I already dropped him off his truck, so that's not an option right now. Yeah. So here's the deal. All those points and rods that we've already won, those are all locked in, and I'm gonna talk to Shimano. We'll get more rods, and we'll do some sort of a trophy fish face-off to break the tie. And if we have to fish for another full 39 hours, we will. This isn't over yet.
39 Hours is presented by Travel Manitoba, Canada's Heart, Beats, and partnered with Tourism Saskatchewan, Shimano, and Travel Manitoba.
I feel destroyed. 39 hours is too long. We gotta not fish so much next time. We gotta like go to Swiss Chalet a few more times, maybe go to arcade, play some video games, if those still exist in this era. It is what it is, and we tried our best to handle our biz and let the chips fall where they may.